ain't afraid to get blood on my hands. Go down.
You ain't much of a...
You're in real trouble now.
Mister?
How?
How's things?
Sorry. Can't put my finger on it.
Son of a bitch, kill him!
Don't you put me down, friend? Oh, boy, I sure owe you one. If I'm gonna be hanged, at least let it be for a crime I committed. If you want to make some easy cash, there's a bunch of high rollers who play poker a couple of floors up over the gunsmith. In Saint Denis.
You best run along before the law comes back for you. Easy, whoa.
You're not supposed to be here.
Mister?
Ass.
Don't worry, I'm just playing with you. Hey, partner.
Turn bastard.
I'm only kidding around.
Thank you.
Hey there, partner.
Morning to you.
Hey there! Just calm down. Let's go, girl. Yeah.
An interesting way of putting it, Seamus.
No doubt. I do interesting very well. It's trusting I don't do so well.
Oh, please. This is Seamus. He's our new partner.
I ain't no such thing.
Prospective new partner, if he likes us.
Liking ain't the problem. Trusting is, as I said.
Keep your voices down.
I don't want my boss here. This is a sideline.
Of course. Look at us. Honest as the day is long.
Exactly.
I'll tell you what. Let us prove ourselves.
Prove ourselves? To this clown? What you talking about?
Good day, Hosea. Good luck with your business dealings.
Listen, he's rough and ready and quick with his tongue, but I swear you can trust him and trust me.
I'm an old man.
You're not old, Seamus.
I'm old enough. And you know why I ain't dead?
You don't trust idiots.
Exactly.
We're not idiots. Let us prove it to you.
Okay. I'll tell you what.
Arthur. Old Bob Crawford and his boys just bought a beautiful stolen stagecoach from upstate. It's in their barn. Now you go get that, and then we can work together.
Who's old Bob Crawford?
An acquaintance of mine.
So you want us to take out your competition?
Well, he's not just an acquaintance, but a cousin. By marriage, I also want to see if you boys got what it takes. Now, you survived that.
Where is he?
Well, he's in a farmhouse just northwest of here called Carmody Dell. It's just up the train tracks as you're heading up towards Fort Wallace. There's also some money in that house, but that's your business, not mine. But don't kill nobody. Folks know we ain't intimate no more, and they'll know it was me.
But you're fine with us robbing your cousin.
By marriage. And yes, I love it.
You heard the man. Let's go rob his cousin.
By marriage.
The way. He said the place is just northwest of here.
Me?
You're the one who's been out gallivanting around here.
That's what you call it. Clearly you've recovered from your bear encounter.
Could have played that better, couldn't you?
Thought you wanted me here to show some strong arm. That's usually how it goes.
Yes, but you know how this works.
Come on, Hosea. That feller's a joke.
And that's why he's perfect. He won't cause us any problems. A safe spot to fence wagons and coaches, that's easy money for us.
I guess you're right.
Come on, it's not like he's asking us to rob a bank. If the two of us can't steal a stagecoach from Seamus' old crooked cousin by marriage, we should hang up our hats now.
How you feeling about things now?
What things?
This place. The gang. Been here a few weeks now.
Good, I think. Better.
I figured more folks would have cut and run on us, given everything that happened.
Like Dutch always says, a lone wolf don't last long out on the plains.
He does like to trot that one out.
People see that, especially when they get a few years on them. Even someone like Micah.
There's a couple of folks I wish had cut and run.
Maybe they'd say the same about you. That must be the place up ahead. We should go on foot from here. Let's see what we're dealing with. Come on. There's the house. I see the barn in the back. Stagecoach has to be in there.
Okay, let's take a quick look at the place.
Anyone around?
Yes. Okay. I reckon we can do it now. I'll head over, distract him by putting on a little show while you sneak into the house, find what you can, then get the stagecoach. Or wait until nightfall. Sneak in, then I'll get the coach. You can try the house. What do you think?
Let's do it now.
Sure. All right, then. Don't follow me.
Wait until...
until I have them distracted outside, then sneak into the house.
My good young man. Fairly well, fairly well. Is your father home, sir?
Sure is.
Get him down. Please, get him down here.
Get lost, mister.
I was lost for many years. I was lost many years. Now I'm not. And you know what? Oh, here he is. Are you the father of the house?
Sure.
Pleasure to meet you. I was just chatting with Junior here.
You selling something, partner?
Free. Final alignment.
What?
Final alignment. The Lord God Almighty.
Oh, whoever built it.
Lord, our brains in here, but our souls is in our backs.
You, sir, your back looks kind of crispy.
Sure.
Get on, dear boy.
Yeah.
They're on to us. We need to get out of here. Get back on the path. Damn it, Arthur, you should have been more careful.
Yeah, sorry. Must have left the dresser open.
So what were you able to lift from the house?
Found some money stashed away. Must be a few hundred, not too bad.
Not bad at all.
This was easier than hunting a 1,000-pound grizzly anyway.
No doubt. I won't forget that in a hurry.
I'm looking forward to your retelling of that one around the campfire.
It wasn't the first time Mr. Matthews had stared death in the eye. And as usual, he did not flinch.
Yeah, exactly. How long you think we're gonna stick around here for?
Not sure. Until we can't, I suppose. Feels like we're starting to get back on our feet, slowly but surely. Just need to keep at it. Dutch has a new money chest stashed in a safe spot away from camp, but it's a long way from being full.
I hope it's not stashed in town like we did in Blackwater. Even if we had to dump the money from the ferry, we could have at least got the rest out if it was hidden someplace else.
No, I think we've learned our lesson there. And a few other lessons besides. Okay, here we are. Just pull the coach into the barn there. Hello, Seamus. We met your cousins.
How was it?
Fine. Nice people.
Park that thing in here. Quickly. Nice work, Hosea.
It was mostly Arthur. Like I said, coarse, but competent.
Here.
Thank you.
If you find any other coaches that need selling, I'll see what I can offer you for it. But discreet, you know.
Of course.
Goodbye, Joe.
I'm heading back to camp, I think. You coming?
Sure. Hey, you're okay, girl.
Arthur.
Dutch, I need you to do me a favor. Nothing too serious. I need you to help Herr Strauss.
I've been working hard, Dutch.
I know. And I know Strauss's business is not too glamorous, but it pays. Please, son, for me.
Okay. Hey. Another day and we're still alive.
Of course we are.
Well, anyway, best not tempt fate.
Whatever you say.
risky kind of morning.
Morning, Mr. Morgan.
Swanson. When are you gonna get your act together?
I'm just minding my own business here.
Can't go on like this.
Arthur.
Morning, Ted.
Good morning.
You look fine.
Okay, Arthur.
Well, don't let me interrupt the beauty routine.
All right.
Make a big pot. I'm starving.
Morning, Mr. Morgan.
What are you making for us?
You'll see.
Okay. Guess it's a surprise, then.
Sure, Arthur.
You okay?
Well, hello.
How are you doing?
Well, I got whiskey in my belly, so I'm good.
All right. Morning.
Good morning, Arthur.
Everyone behaving themselves around here?
Hardly.
Well, I'm sure you have it under control.
Okay.
When is the chow bell gonna ring?
Do you want to cook right or not?
Thank you, Mr. Morgan. Thank you.
Don't worry about it, Reverend.
I made a fool of myself, again.
We've all done that, Reverend.
I'm bitterly ashamed. Really, I am.
Hey there.
Why don't you sit instead of cluttering the place up?
Hi, Jack.
Morning, Uncle Arthur.
You're a good kid.
Thanks, Uncle Arthur.
You seem in a good mood.
I guess.
Well, I won't go spoiling it.
All right then, Arthur.
Hosea, how are you?
Good morning, Arthur.
You're looking good?
Thank you.
don't look so bad.
Oh, yeah. That fight was nothing.
Yeah, you left me to deal with the big guy. Okay, I'll catch you later then.
All right.
Compare thee to.
You tell me, Dutch.
Arthur, what should I compare her to?
An idiot, if you believe his crap. Hey, Molly, that's what you should compare him to.
Arthur Morgan. A man with less poetry in his heart has not walked the earth since Cromwell.
Well, when poetry starts robbing farms and feeding men, I'll take it up.
Oh, it does. In ways you cannot imagine.
There she is.
Hiya, Arthur.
Don't know what we're gonna do with you.
I don't either.
Fuck up. It's gonna be all right.
Sounds good, Arthur.
Mary Beth.
Morning.
Doing a good job there.
Thank you.
Sorry, shouldn't distract you.
Okay, then.
Morning.
Good morning, Arthur.
Doing a good job there.
Thank you, Arthur.
So don't let me disturb you.
Sure, Arthur.
Dutch?
Hello.
Anything I need to worry about?
Not right this minute.
Okay, good.
All right, then.
Hey, Pearson.
Arthur.
Need any supplies?
Always. Can never have too much.
All right. See what I can do. Hi,
Hi
folks.
Mama. Hi.
Hello.
That looks fun.
I guess.
Well, don't let me interrupt you.
Okay.
The boy behaving himself?
For the most part.
Okay, I'll leave you two to it then.
Yeah, goodbye.
There he is.
Hey, Arthur.
Mood seems pretty good around here.
It does.
Well, guess we should enjoy it while it lasts.
This isn't a holiday camp.
Grimshaw get to you.
She's just so mean sometimes.
Her bark's worse than her bite. All right, well, I should be getting on.
Sure, okay. Hey.
Mercy. Come on. Mercy.
Hey, Tilly.
Arthur.
Everything okay?
Oh, yeah. Just doing what I can to help out around here.
Thanks, Tilly.
Sure thing.
What? What? What does that say?
I don't know.
Try again, Jackie. Was punished for his greed and cast out of the
kingdom.
Kingdom. What's a kingdom?
Thank you, Arthur.
I don't know. What, I guess where the king was.
I thought that was a castle.
See, you're smart.
Oh Lord, please end it.
Arthur? Mr. Morgan. Mr. Morgan, you saved my life, and I'm... Well, I'm very grateful.
Don't mention it, Reverend.
I made a fool of myself.
We've all done it.
I get so confused and angry, and then I hear God laughing at me, and I get even angrier, and... Well, I'm a real prize dolt. I know it.
Ha.
Gunslinger can read too, you know.
Oh, don't go putting ideas in his head.
All right, I won't. Okay, well, let's talk more later.
Yeah, all right.
You're only gonna have to shovel that as manure later. Arthur?
Miss Karen, how you getting on?
Fine so far. And to think I was once a damsel in distress, and now they got me protecting the men.
Just stay alert.
Oh, I shall do. If anyone tries anything, I'll blow their heads off.
Hello.
I'm glad I can read, Jack.
It's just too hard sometimes.
That's life, kid. Well, I should get back to it.
Uh-huh.
How's it going?
Good for you.
Hey.
Hey, Arthur.
Another day, another dollar.
Yes, indeed.
Well, we're still here. That's something.
Okay.
Everyone's favorite uncle. Well, at least you're a happy drunk. Well, I'll leave you to your important work.
Howdy! Hello!
So, John, I was talking to little Dick.
This is a fine boy you got.
Yeah, he's mine.
Of course he's yours. It's the truest of gifts, a child. Yet you push him away.
I ain't no kind of father. I wish the boy no harm, but... Well, you know how we live.
We live free.
If you say so.
Jared?
Oh, hi, John. You know, Miss, I've killed girls that betrayed us. It doesn't happen. Is reading betrayal in your world, Miss Grimshaw? Not reading, Miss. Idleness. Idleness is betrayal because it means I work so you don't have to. That's not right, is it?
I guess not, Miss.
You're right, not Missy! On!
Yes.
Hi, Arthur.
You seem to have everything well in order here.
I wouldn't go that far.
Well, it looks pretty good to me. Hey, Mary Beth.
Hello.
Looks like hard work?
Not really.
Anyway, I won't disturb you.
All right.
I've lost my mind, Mr. Morgan. Lost it entirely.
Nice to see you too, Reverend.
I've lost it. I used to be an intellectual. Now I'm just a fool.
Well, I've always been happy as a fool.
You all just laugh at me.